Listcrawler review. One of my fans told me about this site. I couldn't wait to find out. I was overexcited that excitement was short-lived. I checked Listcrawler out while at work. Once I seen how simple it is and seen a lot of ads from females that was on Backpage, I texted everyone I knew from Backpage to tell them about the new site. My only complaint is you have to set up an account to view reviews and write reviews. That is something I'm not willing to do. I texted 10 numbers of females that was 30-minute bus ride from me just to take the site for a test drive. 1 out of 10 replied right away. I told her I would test her with update at 6. 6 came around, she texted me for the update. I told her I was still at work. We would have to hook up Friday. She replied okay. Friday came, I texted her and got no reply. I waited a while, then called her, no answer. She had multiple ads on Listcrawler. I read all the ads again and checked out the pictures just to be on the safe side. By the time I got off work at 8 p.m., I noticed none of the other females replied back. That is when I delete every non-responder's text out my phone on the bus ride home. One of the females texted me asking who I was. I replied, someone that wants to hook up with you, but I erased your number. When you did not reply back within 20 minutes, then I asked for her to send me a pic to refresh my memory. She replied back. I went on Listcrawler to match her number with the profile. When I found her ad, I texted her back to see if she still wanted to hook up. Because she was one of the main females I wanted to do business with, she texted back, no. I don't understand why some females wait hours to reply back instead of right away. I waited an hour, then called her back from a blocked number. She answered on the third ring asking who I was. I made up a name after hearing her voice. I figured something was wrong. Her body was too nice for that ugly voice that was unused to come across. I told her I wanted to hook up. She asked me how much money I got. I replied, 60. She replied, okay. Then asked why I was calling her from a blocked number. I told her to keep her from calling me back down the road. I've been through that too many times. She told me there was a lot of people at her place. She needed 30 minutes to get them to leave. I told her I would call her back in 30 minutes. After I hung up, I went on her ad to get the location where she was. I typed the street names in my GPS. Came up there. There was no hotels in that area. She had to be in one of the apartment complex. I reached out to her again the next day after work. Told her I was ready to hook up. Where to come? She replied, to my house. I have my own room. I said, okay. Text me the address. We hung up. I went back to her ad and read all the ads she been posting for 3 weeks. 3 whole special. Some ads said she don't do anal. Other ads said she do. The price kept changing from ad to ad. And when you look at all the pictures, you can see that most of the pictures are old. I never reached out to her again and she never contacted me. As of right now, things are not looking too good for me to continue to try and hook up with females off of Listcrawler. But we never know what will happen down the road. If you like this video, hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, and comment below.